All right, thanks for staying with us. So today, here's what we found as today's quotes. To effectively communicate, we must realize that we are all different in the way we perceive the world and use this understanding as a guide to our communication with others. That's from Anthony Robbins. Hey, ladies, what do you think? Who do I start with?
Communication is one of the most difficult things in this world. And you know, we take it for granted. We take the words that come out from our mouth, the way it makes people feel, especially in this world of realism. I want to be real. I know. So emotional intelligence is backward because you want to be real. No, so it's a big topic for me. How are you sure that the thing that you want to say is actually the things that come out from your mouth?
You know, there was a day on set here. Sanzi and was it Fumi kept telling me that, Uwa, you said something. I kept arguing. I said, no, I didn't say that. They said, no, you said something. I kept arguing with them. So just don't argue. Just go and watch the repeat, brother. That's why you have a repeat. Honestly speaking, in my head, what I was saying in my head was completely different from what came out of my mouth. Do you understand?
So it does happen.
It just dawned on me that truly we think we're communicating, but we are not. You know, you're just saying something. You don't know what you're saying is different from. So sometimes our thoughts and our words don't align.
Are different, that's
you
true.
You know, so have you had that experience?
Oh, I have, like growing up, it's not like right now when it happens to me, I'm like, okay, here we go. And it's part of why growing, right now, I don't talk a lot. I don't interact with people a lot because it's just this thing of being misunderstood.
So
right?
This thing just said, it doesn't match with your pattern. You know, you know why I'm saying that you're like a very cheerful person. So you see someone and you're like, hi, you don't talk a lot. And like,
no, she doesn't talk to
no.
me.
I don't talk a lot. Yeah. I'm so like, keep to yourself. Don't say anything because you might just say it and, you know, stuff okay. like that. So I get that a lot. You have been a witness.
I have.
So, but I think I've learned that you're really not in control of how people understand exactly. what you're saying. Yes.
I really love this quote about what Anthony Robbins said, because he said people's perception of the world is different. So where you're coming from, your experiences are different. So
there
is no how you're going to say something that somebody will not perceive it differently. So at some point you really have to just, you know what? I've done my best.
Yeah. We have to learn and then give a little room for miscommunication.
True. So effective communication remains one of the biggest struggles we face as a people. And this cuts across all levels, from small family units all the way to governance. And we have Norma Efanga and Barbara Ezeife. They're here to discuss it. But first, let us quickly go into what we found in the news. So who is going to go first? I think we should go with AK's story first.
See me when I was just prepping.
You know, you can't get away easily because you're a toastmaster, auntie. You should be ready all the time.
Please don't report me. Thank you. You know, in class, you're like, hope it's not me. So it just happened. Okay. So my story is actually a story that shocked the tech world this week. And that's the death of GoCaddy's founder, Fahim Saleh. And, you know, to even witness that sight, to find out that his sister was the one that found him. And now the development in the story is saying that his PA might be the one responsible. And he has been working, his name is Therese Devon. He has been working with Fahim since he was 16 and he's 21 now. And they said he got into the building, they said someone got into the building wearing a mask following him. And they also found out that Fahim's credit card was used at a department store to get like cleaning agent and a vacuum. So the police are trying to tie things together. It was also said that Fahim had discovered that he was stealing from him. And instead of, you know, asking him or sacking him, he just said, okay, don't worry, I will term this out and you will pay me back. And somehow they're trying to tie the story to say maybe he couldn't pay back, maybe we don't know yet. And I think the story is unfolding, but it's just shocking.
When I heard that story, I think I sent a voice note to the group. I said this week, because we just had the death of the young pilot, that's her name, right? Arotile, the young lady that the young pilot. Then we now found the story of the GoCaddy CEO. That day I was just heartbroken. Like, can it just get any worse? You know, one thing I think I want us to point out here is now, and I love what you said when we were discussing it just before we started the show, now that is the era of face masks and, you know, everybody putting on shields, protective gears because of the coronavirus.
You have to be very careful.
AK was saying that in her office, they come around once
randomly
in a while
and
to just say, you know what, they stand from a distance, please unveil your mask. I think because they saw somebody wearing black suit with black nose mask and all that. Imagine if the security guards had said, you know what, let's see who you identify yourself. You stand from afar. Maybe, you know. So they just took advantage of this COVID-19, you know, to kill someone very gruesomely in his apartment. That's very, very
sad. It's just
sad.
Terrible. I think I've been reading the tributes, including people, lives he has impacted in Nigeria.
Yes,
and
I think so many there is, people he have just a lot
doesn't,
of nice
He just doesn't stories. Deserve it. And I'm just, the last video
Nobody
I remember, true though, okay. the last video I remember of him was him pleading with Nigerians to, you know, speak up to government and protest against the ban of Gokada and the likes of it. So it's really painful. Like,
absolutely.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I can't, and the, oh my goodness, no.
I don't know what his sister will be going through, seeing that she discovered the body.
Dismembered. That's really, really disheartening.
Really tough, really tough.
Disheartening, like somebody actually came to just pieces you like you were maybe a cow or something. That's really sad.
It's sad.
Sanzi, so what did you find for us?
Okay, so I'm moving all the way to Zamfara State. Zamfara Governor Bello Matawalle. I hope I got the name right. So now he is offering bandits 2 cows for every AK-47 they submit. Now, over the past couple of months, there has been constant looting and raiding and taking people hostages for ransom, you know, like Fulani herdsmen, according to what the news said, they would come in bikes and raid the steal stuff from people. So now he's offering them amnesty, saying that if they would return their AK-47, that they would exchange it for 2 cows. So now a cow average in the north is about 100,000 naira. So he's giving them that to start afresh and start, you know, have something to start off with. And here is my view on this. I think it's really not, if you're going to reform people, this is not the right way to do it. It's about the mind. If they don't have that mental shift that what I'm doing is wrong, there has to be another way. It's only a matter of time before they grow that herd to 5 to 10 and they'll feel a need to, you know, take over another territory and then they'll move on and commit other crimes. That's just my view.
You're spot on and you're just spot on. What is the root of this crime? What is really the problem? Where has amnesty really worked? Where has it really worked? And I think it's about time our government need to wear their thinking cap. Think. There has to be a solution. There has
Employed,
to be a strategy.
If you can't
think. What will 2 cows do? I think it's really absurd the way they come up with these things.
You know, I was going to say that if you juxtapose 2 cows and an AK-47, if you run businesses with both items on a monthly basis, what will bring better... us be realistic. What will bring better returns for you?
Like
you
the hostage situation.
A criminal,
they would make a lot
guns,
more money.
They will make a lot more money.
They'll make more money. So if starting a business is not the problem. Because if starting a business was a problem,
they would not even be in the crime. You know, they would not even have hold the gun in the first place. If they had the capacity to be patient enough for the herds to grow and make money from it, they will not hold a gun in the first place. So I think there should be a lot more creative reforms that our governors, and our leaders.
We need to invest in it.
I'm telling you.
We need to.
Sometimes I just feel we're too lazy. We don't want to think, you know, and find the right solutions. Okay, my story is just a follow up on WAEC. All right, so the federal government is giving school operators 12 days to meet COVID-19 guidelines. Now, I haven't seen that guideline, though, but I hear it's a very, very lengthy one. And they're giving schools 12 days to meet up with these guidelines before they can consider reopening the school. When this WAEC drama happened, because me, I'm inside the matter. My son is supposed to write junior WAEC. I have a friend that both children, in fact, are only 2 children. One is supposed to be graduating from SS3. Yeah. The second one is supposed to be graduating from primary, GS3. No, primary
oh,
6,
oh,
into
oh,
GSS1.
Okay.
You know, this was the perfect year for us to come and celebrate double celebration, double graduation. So I don't know how parents are going to take it because now they are saying that schools must meet those guidelines and the schools themselves have to be the one to vet that it is okay. Then they send to them that they are good and they are ready for reopening. Does it make any sense?
Do we have the capacity to even do that? Because you just mentioned, how can I execute and also judge, you know, how I execute it.
Yeah.
The same thing we're talking about, Uwa. Someone has to really think. People, Thank God we're talking about communication.
It's very, very.
We should have just called it strategic communication, because I don't get all these things. Like, I believe that we have very intelligent, very bright minds. Can we look for them, please? Mm-hmm. Can we please look for them?
I'm telling you, because I you know, this WAEC matter has been going back and forth, and you know, and now it's almost like, you know, some states were not, they were ill prepared, and so some states that have met up with these guidelines, the other states are dragging them behind. So it's a huge conversation that we have to, you know, really, really delve into. But I would say to the government, try as much as possible, like we said, for the Zamfara situation, just be creative, because there are a million and one intelligent people that you can actually ask and pay them for intellectual property. They will give you the right solutions.
Exactly.
Absolutely. We have very good communicators. One is on our set here. And we have some who are going to join us right after the break. Please stay with us. We'll be right back.